Our first mini review this month is Mr. Do for the ColecoVision. This is based on the arcade classic of the same name with some minor changes, nothing really big. For one thing, you'll notice our clown hero is dressed all in white. Doesn't really look much like a clown, does he? Anyhow, the objective is to either clear the stage of the cherries buried in the ground, or defeat all the enemy characters that escape from the middle of the screen. You can do so by launching a bouncy energy ball at them, though with each throw, it takes longer to conjure up another. In total, there are 10 different stages. After the 10th, stage 11 is just stage 1, but a hell of a lot faster. During your cherry collecting, you can also grab bonus items. These will make one of the extra letters appear. Get all letters that spell out extra to get an extra life. The graphics, while slightly different from the original arcade version, are still clean, colorful, and well animated. Music gives you the same track in each level, though another tune or two is present at the right times, clearing a level, losing a life, or when the extra letter is walking around by itself without those blue chompy teeth guys. FX do well in the game, they're just there, it's all good. Control, however, is a bit sluggish. As you can see, you won't always move in the direction that you want to. This is evident with both the Coleco controller or playing it emulated. Trust me, as a kid, you remember stuff like that. The challenge increases as the speed does, so be on your toes. Remember, those enemies can transform into diggers, and they move fast. This game may be your bag, or it may be too weird for you. In any event, try it. Our next review, in fact, is an arcade game. It's the original Altered Beast by Sega, later released as a pack-in for the Genesis console. Regarded by many as a bad side-scrolling beat-em-up, you can play as one of two Centurions who have been called from beyond the grave to mount a rescue attempt of Zeus's daughter, Athena. You may start out puny, but by grabbing these power-up orbs, you can become a sexy, muscly old man! Sorry, Herbert owns, what can I say? So yeah, collect three orbs and you can transform into different animals. Their abilities range from effective and badass to downright lame and useless. I mean, for starters, you get to turn into a werewolf and dragon, your powers range from shooting fireballs to electric bolts, then you get lame-ass shit like the bear who spin jumps and has frozen breath. Maybe that prevents forest fires. Whatever it does it badly. I won't lie though, the graphics are great. Good amount of color, lots of action, but the screen moves kinda slow at times. The players who want their game to be fast, fast, fast might be turned off by that. The music is low and pretty subtle. Sometimes you hardly know it's there, but when you do hear it, it's appropriate for that level. Sound effects are decent enough. Punches and the kicks are nice, but the voices are the ones that really stand out and are cool. Rise from your grave and welcome to your doom are familiar quotes from the game, we all remember that, but more so from the Genesis version. I do wish the control was a bit more responsive or there were some effective moves. Sometimes you won't be able to get the opponents that are in the air, or you won't be able to kick that blue-headed wolf or whatever it is to get the orb, making the level longer. You will die often, especially in your human form. Your punches and kicks just aren't fast enough for some of these enemies. If you have yet to experience the game, I would say try at your own risk. Altered Beast has its moments, but it's just not that great.
Never give up.